Hey, it's Peter Gregg from Miami, Florida, and I'm visiting with a 1DX by Canon, and I recently made a video that showed you 8 things that I particularly liked about this camera that stand out. I don't want everybody to accuse me of being a fanboy, so I'm gonna pick out 5 things I don't like about the Canon 1DX, or maybe some things to be corrected. Well, right off the bat, there's something about spending $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 for a camera, Canon, Nikon, hello, testing 1, 2, where I'm shooting at a wedding. Now, picture this, okay? My first complaint, is that there's no true silent mode. Now, I'm standing up at the front of a church filled with people, a sea of people, all looking at one of two things, either the bride and the groom or me, all right? And I make a noise like that. Kadoosh! It's like bombs bursting in air. It's like, everybody look at me, please. Everybody, please look at me. No, that's embarrassing, guys. I don't want to be embarrassed. I don't like to be embarrassed. It's embarrassing. Did I use that word enough? All right, so let me check that off. I used embarrassed 3 times today. All right, now let's get back to business. Seriously, at $5,000 to $8,000, with all the technology in this, the engineers in Japan, yes, hello? America to Japan, I call in Japan. Yes, I talk Japanese. You didn't know I talk Japanese? I talk Japanese. Toyota, Honda, Nissan, Aso, Yisi. I told you I talk Japanese. Anyway, guys, hello. Please put an electronic shutter mode that would be totally silent. I want to shoot a picture like this. Okay, I just shot 4 pictures in silent mode that doesn't even exist, which means I didn't shoot 4 pictures. But imagine being someplace where there's a viola and a violin playing this very delicate piece, and you come along and you go, kabam? That's rude. That's downright rude. There should be a silent mode on this camera. All right? That's one of 5 things that I don't like about the camera. All right? The next thing that I don't like about the camera that stands out to me and it just jumps out and says, Peter, I know you don't like this. What is it? Oh, let me tell you. It is, they never got the little red boxes where you can tell where the focus points in the camera. They never got that right. They had it right in prior cameras. Yes, I speak English. In prior cameras, in Nikon, they do theirs right. I could see where the focus point is very easily. But in this one, that's number 2. They need to get it right. Now, you guys, you engineers over in Japan that are designing this, I know you can get that right, okay? You made a stellar camera. And the problem is it lights up with a little red box, all right? And when it lights up, it changes or affects the metering system. So they say they don't want the red light there. But in the meanwhile, you're trying to find out which focus points of 41, I have it set to 41, 41 focus points. And it's like, good luck, Sam, all right? So that would be point number 2. Point number 3, all right, you might call this a foul, but it's the size. I like a smaller body. And point number 3 goes along with point number 2, the weight and the size. So this point number 2 and number 3. Make the same camera. Don't dumb it down. Don't water it down. Don't change it to the point where it's a different camera, a different model. Make the same camera so that you could have it so that it's cut off here. Lighter and smaller. The reason for it is it's heavy. It's like a brick. You know, you could use it in self-defense. Boom. I mean, you sucker punch somebody with this in your hand, they've been sucker punched. All right. So it needs to be dumped. Now, don't do away with the heavy-duty body. Okay, there's a reason for that. When you're shooting with the heavy-duty body, all right, it because of its bulk and its weight and its solidness, it gives you added stability so you can use slower shutter speeds. You didn't realize there's a reason for that, right? And you can use the long life battery, okay, which you could put a grip on the other battery, but they really need for us, we work 8, 10, 12 hours at a wedding. It's heavy. It hurts. Hurts the wrist, that hurts the arm. up, down. I mean, people that drink don't go up and down that many times, okay? The heavy drinkers and anyway, let's not get into that. But the weight is number three. The size is number four. So we've got one, two, three, and four. Okay, that's four things I don't like on this camera. The fifth thing that I don't like about the camera is there's these cute little, and they work really great, little function buttons right here. There's two of them, a top one and a lower one. And as you're shooting, when you press in on the function button with your bird finger, I don't know what else to call that finger, number three, you know, you're shooting along, and if you press in the top or the lower function button, it does something, and it gives you a list of choices that you can assign to function button number one, and another list of choices that you can assign to function button number two. So picture this, okay? You're a photographer, you're at a wedding, okay, and you're taking a picture of the bride and the groom somewhere in the reception, or the bride walking down the aisle, and she walks in front of this stained glass window. All of a sudden, you've got a backlit situation. What do? You've got to drop the camera, get over into spot metering mode, take those pictures for that area, and then go back out of spot metering mode, maybe take another picture so you get a nice silhouette. That would be cool too, right? And then you go on your merry way. But the pressure of that moment and to switch your camera over is like high pressure situation. On Nikon, you have on that list where you can press, you can assign one of your function modes to be a spot metering mode. It just drops right into spot metering and you release it, it drops right out. How cool is that? Nikon has it. Why doesn't Canon? It needs to be there. There's so many situations. You go out for dinner and you've got guests and you've got your weapon of choice to protect you because it's so big and heavy, and you're taking pictures and somebody's sitting in front of a glass window. Well, you can't go spot, evaluative. Well, you can if you could assign the spot metering mode to one of your function buttons. So that's number five. That's my five things that I would like to correct about this camera. Okay, the first one is there needs to be a true silent mode. Totally silent. I don't want to be embarrassed anymore. Wait, that's number five for the word embarrassed. Okay, the red boxes so I can see my focus points when I move them around with this awesome joystick. I need that to work properly. The Nikon works properly. Canon can do it too. The third thing that I would mark is that I don't like about the Canon is the size. It needs to be a smaller camera, a smaller form, but the same camera. Don't charge less. Charge the same amount. I want the same camera smaller. And then the fourth thing, is the weight. You're going to make it smaller, make it lighter, okay? But don't change the camera. Charge me the same amount. I just want a lighter, smaller camera. And the fifth thing, I want the ability to assign the spot metering mode to one of the function buttons. Easy as pie. There you got it. Five things that I don't like or I'd like to correct. That's a nicer way to say it. I don't like to be negative. Okay, so five things I'd like to correct about the 1DX are those five things I just mentioned. So if you've got another thing that you would like to comment about, down below, okay, in the doobly-doo, you can write your comments. Remember, we're a family-friendly site. That's my living room. No 4, 5, 3-letter words, nothing like that, okay? Otherwise, I'm going to get my broom and knock you up from here to Canarsie. And no, I don't know where Canarsie is, but you're going to get booted. Nice words. You can say what you want, though, and write your comments, and also subscribe. I'd like to build a bigger subscriber base. I'd like to have more than 4 subscribers watching me, okay? So where it says subscribe, please subscribe. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.